Hello everyone, it's Professor Fiore back once again for some exciting DC electrical circuit analysis. Today we're going to look at a unique circuit called an R-2R ladder network. And this little circuit has some really wide-ranging application in terms of being used in probably a number of little devices that you own, you never even thought of. Digital music, for example. Probably somewhere in there, there's an R2R ladder network. Let's take a look at this thing. First, we are going to begin with a seemingly kind of plain white bread, sort of a little voltage divider circuit. So I've got a 32 volt DC source and a pair of 1K resistors. So we don't have to do any great calculation here, right? We can use a voltage divider rule, which is R2 over R1 plus R2 times the source. 1K over a total of 2K times the source. VA should be 16 volts, right? It's going to split evenly. 16 volts sitting over a 1K, that's 16 milliamps of current, right? This is not some crazy outlandish thing, but let's just verify this. Oh, there you go, 16 volts, okay? But here's where it gets interesting. What I'm going to do is I'm going to start replacing components with equivalents. And we're going to see what happens. So to begin with, I'm going to take R2 and I'm going to replace this with a pair of resistors that will give me the same resistive value. In other words, that will give me 1K. And there we go. It's like magic. You want to see that again? And then, boom, a pair of 2Ks, right? So 2K in parallel with 2K. It's going to give me 1K again. So this circuit, even though it has an extra resistor, should give me the same exact value for VA because this parallel combo is still 1K. It's 1K against 1K. VA should still be 16 volts. Don't believe me? There it is, 16 volts. Now I'm going to continue this process. I'm going to take R3 and I am going to replace it with another equivalent. But in this case, I'm going to turn this into a series equivalent. So that 2K turned into a 1K and a 1K in series, right? So here's where we were. We had the original R2 over here at 2K. This R3 is going to get split into a 1K and a 1K. All right, there's the 1K and the 1K. So now the question becomes, all right, that's still 2K. 2K in parallel 2K is 1K. So VA should be 16 volts. What's VB? Well, if that's 16 volts, that's driving a 1-to-1 voltage divider, right? So this VB should be half of VA. This should be half of 16 volts or 8 volts. Let's check it out. And sure enough, there we go, 16 and 8. Now, what about the currents? What are we seeing for currents? Well, if that's sitting over here, if that's 8 volts with 1K, that should only be 8 mils. All right? So, you know, let's go check the currents for this thing. Open this up a little bit. So our initial current's coming out of here at 16 mils, right? Total current. And what ends up happening? The current basically splits. All right, so here's I of R2, this guy. And we can see that's 8 milliamps, 16 volts. All right, there's the 16 volts we expected, 8 milliamps. The other 8 milliamps that was going through here goes this way. And then that 8 mils through this 1K and this 1K. We get 8 volts on each of those, right? So if I look at R4, right, there's the voltage of 8, there's the current of 8. So VB cuts VA in half, and this current also gets cut in half from back here. That's important to remember. Now, you might ask, hey, you know, what if I didn't know that VA was 16 volts to begin with? How would I solve to find VB? You got a couple ways of doing this. You can just do straight series parallel simplifications, right? In other words, you'd look at the source and say, okay, I've got a 1K, and that's in series with this 3 resistor combo. What is that? That's a 2K R2 over here, which is in parallel with this series combo, right? So you keep flipping back and forth, series, parallel, and that 2K is in parallel with 1 plus 1, which is 2, and so that's 2 in parallel with 2, which is 1, and then a 1 in series with the 1, I do the divider, and off we go, right? If you've already studied Thevenin's theorem, you could actually go from this point, look back in, and see what the Thevenin equivalent is at VA. And just to be complete about it, your Thevenin output voltage would be the divider between 32 and a 1K and a 2K. So you'd get 2/3 of 32 volts, which would be like 21 1/3. And then the Thevenin resistance would be 2K in parallel with 1K because you'd short out the source. And that would be 2/3 of a K. So you'd basically have this 21 1/3 volts and 2/3 of a K for the driving circuit of the 1K and the 1K. Right? And then you could just, that's just a series circuit, and you could calculate out and you'd find that indeed you would get 16 volts across this pair and 8 here and 8 there. Right? If that made no sense to you, don't worry about it. If you haven't studied Thevenin's theorem yet, it's coming up. There is another video that will explain Thevenin's theorem. But just in case you've already been there, I just wanted to throw that in as a freebie. Okay? Beautiful. Now what? Well, I can keep doing this. I can take this 1K and repeat the process. In other words, that's equivalent to a 2K in parallel to 2K, and that second 2K can also be broken up into a 1K and a 1K. And then that 1K, I can do the same thing, right? So I just keep doing. This is where the name R2R comes from. So I finally wind up with something that might look like this, right? I've added a bunch of these. So it's R2R, 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 R. The very last one, the terminating resistor, is still R. But basically, it's all R2R, R2R, all the way through, right? Kind of a obvious name. But what we found, right, because we ended up over here, we had 16 volts, 8 volts. What do you think is going to happen over here? Well, if this is 8, when I analyze this, it's 1 in series with 1, which is 2, in parallel with 2, which is 1, 1K and 1K, right, 1-to-1 voltage divider, that 8's going to drop to 4. This 4 is going to drop to 2 back here. And of course, the currents are going to keep cut in half as well, right? So you got 16, 8 volts, 4 volts, 2 volts, right? 2 volts, and they're all sitting out here, you know, on these resistors. You can either use the voltage or you can use the current. When we look at the currents, because VB compared to VA is half the size, what's going to happen with the current? It's going to get cut in half. VC is half the size of VB, same resistor, half the current. So it just keeps cutting like this. Take a look at the node voltages, right? There you go, 16, 8, 4, 2. If I added another one, turn this into a 2 and then go a 1 and another 1, that would be 1 volt. Add another half a volt, add another quarter of a volt, and it just keeps on going like this. All right, and we can check out the currents too. We're having so much fun. Simulators are nice, you know, you can play these little games with them to say, like, what if, right? What if? So I come over here, I'll just look at R2. This 2K, there's my 8 mils and my 16 volts. Come over here to R4, also a 2K. 8 volts, 4 mils. Come over here to the next one, right? 4 volts, 2 mils. And it just keeps on, right? Keeps on going like this as we keep adding rungs to this ladder. All right, so we can see the technique here. And it doesn't matter that this is a 1K and a 2K. You know, this could be 10K and 20K. This could be, you know, 50K and, you know, 100K, or, you know, 6K and 12K. It doesn't matter. It's just that ratio has to be 2-to-1, R2R. And then the terminating resistor has to be R again. But other than that, you know, you can just keep on going. You could have 16 rungs on this ladder. It still works. Just keeps cutting everything in half. So how is that useful, right? I mentioned digital audio. Well, digital audio, for example, is based on binary, which is a power of 2 system. So you think decimal, it's power of 10 system. So you look at a number, and you know there's a 1's place, a 10's place, a 100's place, a 1,000's place, and so on and so forth, because it's 10 to the 0 power, 10 to the 1st power, 10 to the 2nd power, 10 to the 3rd power, and so on and so forth. Well, in binary, it's base 2. So it's 2 to the 0 power, 2 to the 1st power, 2 to the 2nd power, 2 to the 3rd power for your places. And we only have 0's and 1's. So we have a 1's column, if you will, a 2s, a 4s, an 8s, a 16s, a 32s, and so on and so forth. So we can approximate a value just by using a binary sum. In other words, I can take a value like 1001 and say, well, there's 1 1s, no 2s, no 4s, and 1 8. So that's a 9, right? That's decimal 9 equivalent. And what we do is we essentially take a voltage, like an audio voltage, right, in music, whatever, and we essentially measure it and we turn that voltage into a numeric representation, a binary representation. Now I have maybe a 16-bit binary value, right? I got 16 digits, 16 ones and zeros, basically. And at some point, after I've manipulated this, stored it, you know, whatever I've done with it, transmitted it, I need to turn it back into an audio signal that I can listen to, you know, with my loudspeakers, headphones. So I have to turn it back into a continuous analog waveform, and I need to take those numbers, those bits, and come up with, you know, the summed voltage in this case. So that's how we do it. These would represent these voltage points or these currents. You can do it either way, right? Typically we do it with currents, but you just sum these things up, right? This would be a low significant digit, low significant bit. And then this would be your highest significant, right? This would be the MSB and this would be the LSB. If you've taken some digital coursework, right? This would be a 4-bit value essentially. So you could sum up these voltages, or like I said, you could sum up the currents, and that would give you an analog equivalent. So we would, in typically in audio, like CD quality audio, you would take 44,100 measurements per second. Each one of these measurements would be a 16-bit word. And now you would take this and you would run it through an R2R ladder network. You know, when you're playing this back now, right? You'd have 16 rungs on this ladder, essentially. And you could sum up those individual currents with an op amp, as an example, and come up with this continuously variable voltage, right? Because at 44,100 times a second, you're going to feed new values into here, right? When a little digital circuit will latch those in, then you can take these currents, off you go. All right, that's just like sort of a big textbook, super popular example of it, right? But it's really kind of a cool thing. It's sort of unassuming, just a simple R2R ladder network, and you wouldn't think it could be all that useful. But it turns out to be tremendously useful. You use it all the time, and you don't know it. You know, it's like invisible technology. But now you understand how it works. Pretty cool, huh? Next time.